Now let us learn about convection. Okay. And tell me again, what is a conduction, Bhavya? What is a conduction? Priscilla? Tell me about conduction.
So conduction means the transfer of heat from one substance to another without the movement of the actual particle.
Right. Without the movement of the particle, if heat energy transferred from one point to the another point, it may be from one object to another object, or it may be from one point to the another point, then that type of transmission of heat energy will be called conduction. And conduction requires medium, definitely. And conduction preferably takes place in solid substances. So that is about conduction. Now let us learn about convection. And to understand about convection, let us take one example which is there in your slide. What is there in your slide? One bowl is there, and that bowl is filled with a water, and you are heating that water with a some burner which will be there for a stove. Then what you observe actually? You observe some bubbles in a water. You observe it or not? You observe it or not? Bubbles like whatever is there in your slide. Yes. Right. And
hydrogen molecules.
Right. How heat energy will be transferred here? Heat energy will be transferred in a particular way like this. What happens is, first, when you are heating the bowl, bowl gets heated first, and after bowl gets heated, that heat energy will be transferred to the molecules of the water which are in touch with that base of the bowl actually. And after getting heated, those particles which are touching that base, those will be heated and they will become lighter. And when they become lighter, what happens is they come up actually. And whatever other particles are there, which are not very hotter actually, so those are heavier than these lighter particles, and those particles will come down. Now these will be heated, and when they are heated, these particles which are touching the base now will become lighter and they will come up. So like that, water molecules will come down, touches the base and gets heat energy, and they will become light and they will go up. That means molecules are, those particles are moving to get the heat energy, or particles are not moving here? Particles will move or not in this particular case?
Yes, sir.
Right, particles will move. So by the movement of the particles, if heat energy will be transferred from one point to the another point, then that type of transmission of heat energy will be called convection. What it will be called? Convection actually. So the transmission of heat from one place to the another place by the actual movement of the particles is known as convection. And convection is the mode of heat transfer in liquids and gases. Generally, I told you just now only, most probably conduction will take place in solids, but whereas convection will take place probably, most probably in which substances? Liquids and gases. And in liquids also, you can observe that particular process while you are heating the water. Now after closing this class, what you do is you take one bowl and you pour water into that, and you heat it and observe. Water particles are moving up and down like that, you can see. You can observe water particles are coming up. Can you observe it? Whether we observe it or not? Arna, Bhavya, Priscilla and Unmana.
Yes, sir.
Right, so we observe it. After closing the class also, I told you to do this experiment. And this method of transmission of heat energy will be called what? Convection. And convection will take place mostly in what? Liquids and gases. So that's why only I said conduction will be most probably in solids. In convection, most transmission of heat energy will take place by what? Convection. So in liquids and gases, convection, and in solid substances, conduction will happen. But now tell me, for conduction and convection, whether the medium is required or without medium also heat energy will transfer for conduction and convection. Have you understood my question, Priscilla? Priscilla? Are you there, Priscilla?
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. I had an issue.
Right. So, tell me, convection generally takes place in liquids and gases.
Yes.
Right. So, for conduction and convection, whether medium is required or medium is not required?
And medium is required.
Right, very good. Medium is required for conduction and convection. I said conduction will most probably takes place in solid substances and convection will takes place in liquids and gases. Right? And this convection generally will have some applications also, and we have to learn about that applications also. And see here, to understand about convection, you have to understand like this. Movement of molecules is not possible in solids since they are closely packed. So that's why convection will not take place in solid substances. Whether convection takes place in solids? Whether convection can happen in solid substances? Unmana?
No, sir.
Okay. So why conduction will not take place? Because in solid substances, the molecules or the particles are very, very closely packed and they are very tightly bound with each other. So that's why convection will not take place. And generally, in liquids and gases, transfer of heat energy will take place by convection. Even though you said conduction is also possible, but transfer of heat energy in liquids and gases takes place only by convection. So just now I said a medium is required for transfer of heat by convection, and even for a conduction also medium is required. So heat cannot be transferred by convection in vacuum. Why in vacuum it will not take place? Even convection also will not take place. Because no particles are there, no medium is there in it. When no medium is there, conduction and convection cannot happen. And next, by the process of convection, transfer of heat is always vertically upwards. So upward will be there. Convection, you know that what will happen? Heat energy, they will get, just now I said, water molecules will get heat energy and they will go up. And again, whatever the water molecules which are touching the base will be heated and they will go up. So always vertically they will move upwards. And this can be observed in some other applications also. So we are learning about those applications now. So convection in liquids, on heating the part of the liquid in the vessel which is in contact with the surface, with the source of heat, becomes warmer. And that warmer liquid becomes lighter and rises up, and all these things I said just now, isn't it? Right. Now, let us learn about convection current. So, convection currents generally, what do you mean by it? So, let us try to understand what hot air will do. Generally, hot air will rise up because it is lighter than the cold air. So when hot air rises, cold air takes its place. That means hot air will come up, cold air will go down. So this type of a movement of hot and cold air known as convection currents. What it will be called? Convection currents. And these convection currents can be observed in refrigerators, thunderstorm, steaming of beverages, campfires, and all these things, what we can observe? Convection currents. So convection current means what? Hot air will go up and cool air will come down. So if that process takes place, that is called convection currents actually. And you are going to understand about such kind of convection current as a land breeze and sea breeze. What we mean by land breeze and what we mean by sea breeze. So that's what we are going to learn now. Now generally the cold air will blow from land towards sea during the night is called land breeze. And land being a good absorber of heat energy, it is also a good radiator. Okay, so let me explain. Now generally in night time, whether temperature will be less or more in a night time? Priscilla, temperature will be less or more?
Yes, sir, it will be less.
It will be less in night, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Right. So at night, what happens is whatever the land is there, generally during the day, land will be heated to very large temperature as it is a good absorber of heat energy. And then what happens is hot air will be there on the land. And when in the night time, generally what happens? That whatever hot air is there, whatever hot air is there, that air will flow. So from one side to the another side. So here in a night, generally what happens is you observe beaches. At the beaches, generally what will be there? Water and sand will be there or not? Water and sand will be there or not? At beaches. Unmana?
Yes, sir.
Right. So water and land will be there. And maybe you know that during the night, the cold air, as temperature is less at night, what happens is the air whichever is touching the land will become cooler. And when it is cooler, maybe you know that it will come down. And maybe you know that whatever the water is there, water is a poor conductor of heat energy. And during the day, what happens is whatever the air which is touching that water will be heated up. That means it will become light, and that lighter air now will come towards the land, and whatever cool air is there to the land, that will move towards the sea. So like that, cool air will flow from land to the sea in night time, and that will be called land breeze. That means air is moving from land to sea. That's why we are calling it as land breeze actually. And this is due to what? Temperature difference, and thereby cool air is moving from one part to the another part. And similarly, you can understand about the sea breeze. That means now air will move from sea to land.
Sea to land.
Okay, so this will be called a sea breeze actually. So what is a sea breeze?
Sir, the cold air from the sea, the cold air from the sea moves towards the land, and the hot air from the land rises up and goes to the sea.
Right. The cold air blowing from the sea towards the land during the day. And maybe you know that during the day, land is a good absorber of heat energy. So when land is a good absorber of heat energy, whatever the air which is there on the land will be very warm. And when it is very warm, what happens is it will become lighter. And when it becomes lighter, low pressure will be there. And that air will move towards the See, actually, maybe you know that during the day, water, as you know that it is a poor conductor of heat energy. So on the water, whatever the air is there, that will be a little bit cooler. And that cool, whatever air is there, that will have high pressure. And that high pressure, whatever air is there on the water, will move towards the land, as warm air will be there on the land and that will move toward the water actually. So now air is coming from water to the land. That's why we are calling it as sea breeze actually. So sea breeze or land breeze are examples of convection currents. That means hot air will move from one point to the another point. So in this way you can understand about convection currents. Okay, land breeze and sea breeze. And land breeze and sea breeze are applications of what? Convection currents. And what do you mean by convection currents? Hot air flowing from one part to the another part. So that will be called convection currents. And when hot air is moving from one part to the another part, that particular part where this warm air is there will be filled with a cool air actually. So this will be called convection currents, and that can be understood in land breeze and sea breeze. Now again tell me, in a land breeze and sea breeze, whether medium is there or medium is not there? Arna? Arna?
Yes, sir.
In case of this convection current, that means land breeze and sea breeze, medium is there or medium is not there?
Medium is there.
Right. Medium definitely must be for conduction and convection process. Now, we are going to learn about one more type of a transmission of heat energy. And that, let us attempt this question, and after that, one more type of a transfer of heat energy I am going to explain. So land and sea breezes are based on, tell me which process? Tell me which one is correct option in these four, A, B, C, D.
The phenomenon of convection of heat.
Very good. The phenomena of convection of heat. Priscilla, which is right option?
The phenomenon of absorption and radiation of heat.
Radiation. Whether radiation is there in this case, land breeze and sea breeze? Medium is there or not? Without medium, heat energy is flowing. Or with the medium, it is flowing. In case of land breeze and sea breeze. Priscilla. Medium is there or not?
Yes, sir. Medium is there.
When medium is there, it may be conduction or convection. Conduction, to have a conduction, particles must not move. But here air is moving from one part to the another part. That means particles are moving. When particles are moving, then that type of transfer of heat energy will be called convection. So definitely land and sea breeze are examples of what? Convection only. So the phenomena of convection of heat. Okay, which is the right option now? Which is the right option, Priscilla?
Sir, the phenomenon of convection of heat.
Very good. So B is the right option. Vasala, try to understand. And if anything not understood, try to message me and I will clarify your doubt, as you are only in listening mode. Okay. Right.